At one point, you did, as it went to commercial, Martin O'Malley was asking for 10 more seconds.
Oh, yes.
And you just cut him off hard.
You know, I'm hearing in my ear go to a commercial break, and the sad part of it, not only did I cut him off, but I cut him off to promote, coming up, Anger in America.
And here's a good example. Now, Martin O'Malley got less time than the other two candidates. One could argue that, based on the polls, that makes sense. Is it true that he did approach the table that you were moderating from at commercial breaks?
The commercial breaks, I didn't know what to expect in the commercial break. A couple of times he walked up. He made no requests. I mean, he simply he came up one time and said, "How you doing?" I'm like, "Great, how you doing?" And then he came up another time and suggested that, boy, he would like to have gotten that conversation regarding a question on the heroin epidemic in the United States. But he was very friendly. You know, the candidates kind of, during the commercial break, many of them would disappear.
Would just walk off stage?
Well, they would, yeah, I mean, you know, use a restroom or wherever. They'd walk off stage. So very often, you know, the stage manager would say, 30 seconds coming back, and there was no one out there.
Yeah.
And I look at Andrew like, is there a plan for this if nobody comes back? But they did.
I think the plan is you say, I believe if Bernie Sanders was here, he would say this.
Yeah. Exactly.
One of the things now is moderators of debates are, in a strange way, being reviewed as much as the candidates. Were you aware of that going into
it? I was aware of that. At one point, one of my producers came out and she wrote something on a pad, says, you know, good Twitter stuff. And that was the only, I didn't bring out a phone or anything, and I still have only barely.
That's a good call. I think if you were reading tweets about you during the debate.
Hang on one second. This is a good one or a bad one. No, but I recognize, having watched the debate cycle, that, you know, the moderators are judged just as much as the candidates are, and that puts a lot of pressure on it as well. But what we try to do is just prepare in a way that I wanted to sit there on behalf of the voter, you know, and wanted to shine some light. What are the real differences between you folks on these issues? And I think we accomplished that. That's all I set out to do, not to, you know, try to stay out of the news as much as I could.
Now, you did a great job, but with all due respect, that is, of the debates we've seen this year, you did the easy one.
You think?
Yeah. You did the three people who kind of listen to one another and don't scream and yell the whole time.
There's that, yeah.
Because I will say, in defense of the Republican candidates, 9 or 10 is so much harder to get your point across, and I feel like there's a lot more desperation to jump in to cut people off. Hypothetically, would you want to moderate a GOP debate?
I would. I mean, I love the political process. I love all this stuff. It's noisy and it's messy, but it's what we do in America. And I think it's, you know, it's just personally, I enjoy it. I would love to be in the seat for a Republican debate.
One of the things that seemed to happen last night, Hillary Clinton seemed to tie herself as often as possible to the Obama administration.
She did.
Were you surprised, or was that something you maybe saw coming going
into
it? No,
you know, one of the things in preparing, you know, we look back at what they've been saying over the last few weeks. We knew where the points of disagreement were, and, you know, we fashioned our questions to try to shine light there. She'd kind of hinted at it, but I didn't expect in the big way that she did, in which she kind of aligned herself with the president. I think that's, you know, I'm not a political analyst, but I think she was trying to put herself in a position where, listen, this is the tried and true course for Democrats, and perhaps painting Sanders is more risky. That's the only thing I can imagine, but it did come off as a bit of a surprise.